guys, what's going on? It's Ash here coming at you today in Raid Shadow Legends. I am joined by my good friend Darth Microtransaction. Darth, welcome back to the channel, man. How you doing?
Doing really good today, Ash. How are you doing?
Good. I'm doing well. When's the last time that you didn't have long hair?
This is an awkward conversation.
Well, that's a question. Probably at least 6 years ago, if I remember correctly.
Are there any pictures of you out there? I wonder what you look like. I probably wouldn't even recognize you.
I'm sure there's plenty of them. I mean, I used to have a Facebook and stuff, so I'm sure someone dug.
I meant like content creator. I'm not going to stalk your life, bro.
No, not as a content creator. Actually, I take that back. Here's a little secret that I don't think I've ever said on my channel before. My channel before was Darth Microtransaction used to be called Casey Talks Life.
I literally
would just tell stories about my day, like selling cars and stuff. I don't know why,
and you had short hair.
I had short hair.
So you're a car salesman. You had a Casey Talks Life, and your name is Casey, apparently. So we know a lot about you. This is a in-depth interview, guys. This is what you tuned in for, right?
Yes. Possibly.
Darth, thank you for sharing that with us. I will, we'll go subscribe to that channel after this. But we actually have you on the channel talking about a very, very important topic. It is each of us kind of sharing in a very therapeutic way the five worst mistakes, aka 5 + 5 = 10, title of this video, that you can possibly make inside this game. So, I mean, you're the guest, man. We're going to kick it off with, your biggest mistake.
Biggest one right off the bat for you, pal. Won't make you wait. Is I post shards as soon as I get them, literally every time. And I know I shouldn't do
what?
It.
It's like, is a dumb one.
It's not the best decision. I mean, you should probably wait for the X10 or the fill the bar for the 150 for your countess. But unfortunately, I basically one time the whammies every time I get one.
Wow. So you've never done a 10 time pull on your account?
Well, let's not go crazy.
Okay.
I mean, I've been known to purchase a few shards.
Okay. I got you. All right. So, wow. That is a big one. So, why is that a mistake? In case someone's a brand new player watching this video.
All right. Well, for the people who might not know, pulling shards outside of an event is very wasteful because a lot of the times you can get extra value from that shard, be it twice the chance to get a legendary, complete for a fusion, whatever. But I do them as soon as I get them.
Okay.
And you probably don't want to do that.
Yeah. I mean, your best bet is holding your shards for a 2x event where you get a double chance to pull a legendary champion or epic champion out of those shards. And they have like these challenges and events and tournaments inside the game where you can get a bunch of rewards, including up till level 5 chickens and legendary books. All right. That was a good one, man. That was a good one. Wow. All right. My number one mistake. This is kind of it's weird. It's not as good as yours. But it's a big one, right? And it's not something that people talk about all the time.
And I'm curious.
I feel like it is focusing on characters that you don't need or champions that are not a huge upgrade for you, right? And this is a sneaky one because some people might hear this and be like, okay, like who cares? Focusing on the wrong champion, whatever. But it's like such a, and this is something that I know both of us have an appreciation for because we have a free-to-play account too. But the amount of resources in this freaking game that goes into upgrading one champion, talking about potion keeps and mastery farming and artifact farming and endless campaign farming for food, dude. It's a lot that goes into one champion. So if you upgrade a champion who's, 20% less of a fit for your team or your account than another champion, well, that's a huge waste, in aggregate, all those resources. So that's something that I've done, a lot. Luckily, I haven't had many huge mistakes on my free-to-play account, but I've done it a lot on my main account. Of course, money does solve a few of that, being pay to win. But at the end of the day, it's still a mistake. It's still a mistake. So, have you done that before?
Yeah, all too often, my friend.
Was there ever a champion that you upgraded? You spent a lot on whatever you did. You maxed them out, and then
are you gonna make me say my 5 Nethros? Is ever this is going? I'm gonna have to mention how many Nethros I built just for the videos.
Oh, yeah,
video? What, 4 Macabs, 5 Nethros, and let's not even go into the Richtoff.
First of all, I like Richtoff, but here's the thing, right? Be real with me. Have you ever made a guide on a champion and like kind of talking yourself up about like, yeah, this is a good champion. Like you almost make yourself believe it. And then you look back like 6 months later, like that champion's not that good.
Yeah,
I did.
Okay,
I did so once.
Maybe Solas.
Solas.
maybe soulless and astrolith. You know, I mean, back in the day, I made a hell of an astrolith guide, I gotta say, you know.
I did it twice. And it's like, it's not like we do it on purpose. I'm not trying to like pull one over on my viewers. It's just like the champion is new and you're like, okay, I'm finding some potential here. I did it with Avir the Alchemage, who like is a good enough rare, but I was like, this is a game-changing rare, you know, like, but
game-changing.
Yeah, but he's not, I don't think, you know. And then the other one that I did it on is Bergoth the Malformed, the fusion. Oh, I was like, this is so cool. He has a passive that can heal your whole team. Ah! But like, I feel like, you know, even us as content creators, the reason I say all that is I feel like players make the same mistake, right? Like a new shiny toy oftentimes is better in your mind than they might actually be in game. And even when you invest in them, I'm sure you've done the same thing. Like even when you max them out, sometimes you're like, ah, yeah, they're pretty good. I'll put them on this team. And then you're like, no, this champion is a year old is better, you know? Anyway, that's my number one. What's your number two mistake?
I've done that one a few times, but I was going to say, it's interesting, it's kind of the opposite of that, which is focusing on the character that is kind of a personal favorite maybe, but not necessarily something that builds the account of what I need. So it's kind of similar, because like I'll give you an example, okay? So in mine, for instance, I really need a defense down and weaken. Like I don't ever have one in my team until I got Dracomorph literally out of a single shard. And what I could have done to kind of fix this problem and make a real spider team is I could have just built the guy who's nearly named Spider. You know what I mean?
Yeah, go figure.
But I didn't want to because it felt like, for some reason, the cheap way out. So I built this ridiculous, like, long beard plus four royal guards who charged in to get the weaken from the long beard. It was just stupid, dude. It worked, but like half the time. And I ran that for entirely too long because I just didn't want to build the epic, you know? So
it's like a meme somewhere at Plenum headquarters. They're like, dude, we named the dude Spider and he's still not using him on Spider.
That's a cute outfit. Did your husband give it to you?
Yeah, it seems a little obvious, but really put two and two together on that one, I guess.
That's a good one. So basically, investing in a champion you like that might not be as necessary as a champion you don't like, but might be more necessary under teams.
Refusing to build the correct one, I guess, would be
okay. Even though you know in your gut which champion it is. My number two is a more obvious one. This pertains mainly to newer players, but I feel like we have to have a comprehensive video here. And that is just not using the arena early on. As much as it's broken right now, it's tough, man. On my free-to-play, I'm sure you're the same. It's like I'm rocking. Oh, yeah. Forget gold, forget silver. I'm in bronze, bro. But that being said, I still do it, and I still think it's important for everybody to play arena.
You have to.
at least trying to get in 10 battles a day, you know? Forget about the 24-hour no-lifers, you know? But, like, get like at least 10 battles in a day, I feel like.
It takes so long to do
it. It does, and it's kind of tedious, you know? But, I mean, you know, it's been said a billion times. I'll make it short and sweet, but those arena, those Great Hall perks help you everywhere in the game and they stay with you forever. So it should be a huge area of focus for every player. So big mistake is not playing in the arena thinking, I'll get to it. And then you get to it, you know, 8 months later and you look back and you think, I should have done that way, way long ago. So that's
I'm
my
guilty of that one. Definitely. I'm guilty of like all of these actually. Now that I think of it, I'm like, you know what? Maybe I am the dumbest player alive. I've done all of these.
Now I got a new thumbnail of you. The dumbest player alive, yeah. Exclusive interview. Yeah.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it.
Red arrow, giant circle. Oh.
You know it, man. All right, so what's your number two?
Number three for me is spending $16,000 on Raid Challenge. Like, not going free to play sooner, realizing that, you know, you don't need to spend money in the game to... When I beat Dragon 20, the next... you know, $15,000 didn't really make that Dragon 20 that much more enjoyable. You know, does that make sense?
First of all, I'm not like judging you because God knows how much I spent in this game, but it sounds really bad when you say $16,000 on a mobile game.
No, you know? I mean, it doesn't just sound, it is really bad. You know what I mean? It's like, yeah, no, it sounds like it is.
Oh, man. Yeah, cue like Scrooge McDuck jumping in the pile of money at Plarium headquarters, right?
$22 million in three fucking hours!
Wow.
Somewhere Brad is over here just like face-palming, you know?
Absolutely, dude. Okay, so basically spending too much money in the game was a mistake for you.
Yeah, 100%.
Okay, that's a good one, man. I mean, going back, if you could replay things exactly the way that you did, you know, starting the game exactly the time that you did, if you could do things over, would you just go 100% free to play, or would you spend like strategically a little bit here and there?
I think the this is just my personal opinion, because in everyone's finances are different, but I think the probably the optimal way to play this game is Raid Pass card is fine, and the monthly gym thing that's like $10 or whatever and gives you a large amount of gems, totally fine. Like, if that's what you want to do, totally fine. And, you know, if you want to buy a couple Void Shards now and then, fine. Just don't do what I believe the majority of the people Plarium is looking for do, which is get really into the game and have that constant hope of, I want to po X character or I want to po a legendary. Because if you get into that feeling, then it's a slow, you know, just how much money do I throw into this hole to chase that dopamine, basically. I mean, you know, gambling 101. So that's would be my recommendation personally. The monthly stuff, totally cool. Take a shot with a Void Shard now and then. Other than that, like, you don't really need to, because you can beat almost everything in this game free to play, or you can beat everything in this game free to play. It's just a matter of how quickly can you do it. And I would argue doing it quicker than the next guy doesn't even matter anymore. I mean, if you saw in my own personal PvP experience in the last week, I spent 16 grand, like you guys already know. It doesn't even matter. I'm ahead of literally no one. It didn't help me at all.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So there's no point in this game to be better than the next person.
Totally agree. You know, unless they institute like a really robust PvP system, what does it even matter if you farm dungeon 10 seconds faster or take 8 turns less than your clanmate and, you know, beating a Doom Tower level? But I do think it's clever that they add all that stuff, you know, like, anyway, with that being said, good one. My next one is very similar to that one, so I'll go through it quickly, but it's basically spending money on the wrong things. Like, I hate to admit this, but I've bought, especially early on, I bought a lot of accessory sets. I don't even know why, but that's like the worst thing you can spend money on. Unless like it's your very first 6-star and you're just, you know, you got $20 to burn and you want to max out your Kale and you can't beat Spider, whatever, you know? But other than that, like, what am I doing? Why am I spending $20 on 3 accessories, dude? Not just that, I spent money on dumber things than that, I'm sure, you know? So it's to your point, though. Listen, don't chase champions in this game, meaning don't just pull a bunch of shards. I mean, people need to understand, and I'm sure you've mentioned this to your audience, but like, when I do shard opening videos, I don't need my 60th legendary champion or whatever, right? I'm just doing it for the video, and it'd be fun to do a guide or whatever for the content, you know?
Yeah.
But if I wasn't making content, I have the champions I need to do everything that I need to do in the game, to your point about Dragon 20, right? So if I'm improving my speed, what does it really matter? I'm not staying up until 3 a.m. on Sunday night, personally, here on the East Coast, to compete in the PvP arena, so it doesn't really matter to me. So I guess that example pertains to me personally, but it should pertain to everybody. Think about what you want out of this game, because you can beat this game using all free-to-play champions, using daily login rewards, using Doom Tower champions, Archmage Helmet, and Scylla the Drake, and Grush the Mangler, and Haikatoon. Like, anybody that you get for free will eventually get you to the end game, and you're gonna have a lot of fun doing it, you know? So I'm not trying to hate on the game. I'm just saying you don't need to spend a lot of money, to your same point. So,
yep, agreed.
Not to belabor that point, what's your number 5?
I want to say 4.
4? Dude, one of these days 4. I'll get the numbers right.
Well, you're terrifically old.
So these points are kind of blurring together at this point, because these are all segueing nicely into.
It's all about like, don't spend money, don't spend money.
Yeah, don't spend money, spend on the right thing. And this one is caring too much about the game. Like, the game is most optimally played as a casual gacha game you play on occasion, I think. And the game, in my personal opinion, gets progressively worse the deeper and deeper you get into it. That's just how I see the game, okay? I mean, other people may disagree, and that's fine. But that's just how I see it. So for me personally, I've been really deep into the game. You know, I was a Plarium modder. I was in a content creation program. I literally make a living off playing the game. And at a certain point, like, the funnest I had was being free to play right in the beginning and just not really caring at all. You know what I mean? And just trying to have the most casual amount of fun I could have. And I think I'm going to take that lesson I've learned and apply it to pretty much every game going forward, which is it's more enjoyable for myself and the audience the more you basically don't care about the longevity and all this stuff and, you know, get ingrained in the culture and the community and just play the game for fun and show that to your audience. And I think that's basically what I've learned.
I don't know if I disagree per se, because I think I agree thematically with your point. But me, I play the game a lot. It's still for fun, obviously, and I still enjoy it. But I do pick and choose. Like, I'm not on this game for 20 hours a day or whatever, which you could very well be, you know? I feel like, for me, your point is well taken. But for me, the way I would say it, in my own personal case, is that, you know, I love this game. It's really, really fun to play. It's not my life by any measure. But at the same time, like, I don't feel obligated to do everything every day, you know? Even though we just said you better do 10 arena battles a day or else. But I don't feel obligated. If I don't play the game for an entire day, if I miss my clan boss battles, like, I'm not getting upset about it. This is not my job. It's a game, you know? So point well taken, man. I'm going to cover some really, really dumb, easy ones. It's a 2-for-1 here. Using books on lower rarity champions is an awful, awful decision. So using a legendary book to book up an epic just because you don't have any epic books, or using an epic book to book up a rare just because you don't have any rare books. Don't do that ever, ever, ever. Wait. And also using higher rarity champions as food. It's very tempting to say, oh, I really want to get my you know, Kale to 5 stars. I'll just sacrifice this solid epic champion that I'm going to need later for whatever faction wars or whatever, you know? So those are kind of a 2-for-1. I think that it's really dumb stuff, but you know, it's mistakes that everybody makes.
Yep. I actually did one of those. So I fed my, even recently on my free to play account, I fed my soul drinker. I think it was to level the Aethel in the beginning.
Okay. Did you do that just to make a video about your mistake?
No, that would have been brilliant.
That would have been brilliant. I made a mistake, guys.
Yeah, no, I didn't really.
Hey, you mentioned that you used to be an official raid content creator. Can you give me an exclusive? Or do you get along with Plarium now or no?
I mean, I'm have cool you reached with out? The relationship we have, which is like we don't talk to each other at all.
I mean, so that, like, that's kind of like you've been married for 20 years. That's where you're at.
Yeah, you know, we're in the separate beds.
Okay, and, you're in separate bedrooms.
Pretty okay with that, you know.
Okay, fair enough.
So it makes it easy enough for me to just, like, play the game casually and not really worry about, you know, the latest news and what's going on in the Discord. Like, I don't read any of that. I don't really read the Reddit. I didn't even know about the toolkit that Coldbrew showed it to me. So it's, like, it's kind of cool being isolated from all that, to be honest.
Okay, well, I'm glad you're doing well. You guys are doing well. What's your last one, man?
My last one is not preparing for events that I care about. So to give you an idea, as most people who have watched me for, you know, the last 2 years or whatever know, Dracomorph was my white whale, my Moby Dick, right? And so I was attempting to get him. The thing was, is I had already basically used the vast majority of my resources on my account with a previous X2, which then wrote into the X10 for Dracomorph. Now, they didn't announce the X10 for Dracomorph, and I couldn't abuse my inside information at the time because they didn't really let us know. It just kind of came out of nowhere, right? So I wasn't really prepared, and I ended up dropping like over $600 just during that day trying to get him during the X2. Long story short, we obviously didn't. And, you know, if I had prepared and just waited for the day to come, you know what I mean? The Dracomorph was the one that they were showing on the shard thing. It would have been a lot easier for me. I would have probably got him then. And, you know, who knows? I'd probably still be playing my main. So it's not preparing for the stuff that you probably actually are waiting for.
Okay. I like that. And, you know, if I can be so bold as to add on to that too, I feel like in terms of preparedness, like using your energy at inopportune times too, right? Like, so if there's like spending, you know, 100 auto attacks or auto clicking or doing whatever you do to farm on Ice Golem the day before an Ice Golem tournament starts. You know, not just being efficient in preparation with your energy as well, right? I think that's it. That's one that I actually do a lot, especially on my main account, because I have a bad habit of not really paying attention to the events in the tournaments. And I'm like, oh, wow, why did I just do that? Why did I just spend 3,000 energy when the next day I could have gotten two legendary books if I had done it, you know? So that was your last one, man. My last one is going to be, I think this is an important one again for the early game as well as the mid game, but it's really focusing on too many champions, you know, especially in the early game, right? So I feel like the first order of business inside this game, and I experienced this firsthand on my free to play as well, and it's just like you six star your Kayle, right? Or if you're, you know, going to be a counterculture rebel, go with Elhane or whoever it is. Your starting champion should be six starred, and then like work on your next champion. But I think that in the first go round, I was all over the place. I had like 15 champions that I was trying to work on. There's no way I'm going to be able to put any halfway decent artifacts on those champions. And like, I was working so long on, you know, feeding for these champions and upgrading these champions that I wasn't able to focus on like Dragon's Lair to get some artifacts on them because I was spread way too thin. So I think that, you know, focusing on too many champions, we already talked about focusing on champions you don't need and how to get value out of free champions, which are tremendous in this game. But really, I had my priorities wrong, man. I was just going, I was like, ooh, new shiny object. I want this one. New shiny object. I want this one. So I think that even the same thing with fusions, man. Like, I think that sometimes the right decision is just passing, even if it looks like a great champion.
I agree, you know, on that. Yeah.
Contract creators like us, you know, we're always going to cover the new champions, but it's okay to be like, no, I got plenty on my plate right now. You know, I'm going to pass, you know? So that is my last one, man. I guess that's going to do it.
That's going to wrap it up, man.
Yeah.
Well, the last one for me to add here is just enjoy the game for what it is. That's the best way, man. Just have a good time playing it and get the free rewards that you can. I'm kind of excited because it seems like they keep adding more additional slow rewards, you know, in the game. And I think that it looks like it's slowly getting better over time, so.
Heck yeah, man. All right. Well, hey, thanks so much for coming on the channel. Guys, good news. The video is over here, but it doesn't have to be over for you guys. You can go over to Dark Microtransactions YouTube channel, and we're actually recording a collab right after this one talking about what we learned as free-to-play players. The link will be in the description below. Dark, thanks for coming on, man. Appreciate it.
Appreciate the time, Ash.
No problem. I appreciate you guys for watching all the way till the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, take care, guys.